The Owl Creek Watershed is situated in northeast Mississippi. The soils there are a little bit more highly erodible. There's more topography on the landscape. And that watershed actually flows north into the Little Hatchie Watershed and then eventually into the Mississippi River Basin. So the rain falls, it moves pollutants from the landscape into a water body in that watershed. And that could be anything from sediment to fertilizers to pathogens, just depending on the land use in the watershed. So in Owl Creek, the pollutant of concern is sediment. Here in Mississippi, the Mississippi Department of Environmental Quality delivers the 319 program, and they typically work with coordinators on the ground, whether it's the Soil and Water Conservation Districts, Delta Farm, NRCS agencies, a variety of different partners that help them coordinate stakeholders, identify what those solutions are going to be, and that really is helpful to the process.
Typically what a 319 project is we go in and we implement best management practices on ag lands in the watershed from the soil and water perspective. We use NRCS staff and district staff in the county offices because they know their farmers or landowners in those watersheds. And then we have an education component to it where we'll hold a landowner meeting. We'll invite everybody that owns property or has a tract number, and we'll kind of explain what we're going to do with the project, whether we're putting in grade stabilization structures, we're doing stream bank and shoreline protection. I present that to them, and then we work with them through a 60-40 cost share to put these practices on the ground.
Anytime you're controlling the sediment and keeping it from going downstream, it keeps the nutrients there on the farm. Before we did the use exclusion on the streams, the cows just had free access to the creek, and they were putting manure in the creek and causing excessive erosion, and we decided to, you know, fence the entire little stream out and put crossings throughout, and to allow the cows cross in those specific areas, and it allows for vegetation to grow and hold that sediment in place.
In the case of Owl Creek, many of the practices identified, like stream crossings or the exclusion fencing, each one of those is a benefit to the cattle production system and infrastructure, water access, or cattle safety, and at the same time, each one of those mitigates and reduces soil loss and erosion to the watershed.
What we're showcasing with a lot of this will be that you can do an intensive rotational grazing when you do the cross fencing. If you do it right and you plan and you have enough grazing cells, you can move your cattle around. And then you also have these feeding pads where they're not mired up in the muck and everything in the winter times, causing diseases and foot rot and things like that. It's better health for the animals.
You're preventing a problem from happening, essentially. A lot of people don't want to put fences in certain places because they think they won't use them. And I'm keeping that ditch from getting worse over the years and losing more soil. Certain practices can save you a lot of land in the long run. They're not making any more land. You've got to protect that natural resource. The water quality is a lot better because I've been able to keep things from eroding. You don't see a lot of sediment going downstream. The water's clean every time it rains. All the runoff off the fields is clean. Any program that I can apply for, I apply for just because of the benefits for the land, and I would highly recommend it for anyone.
Logan loves cattle, he loves the farm, so you can see we've done a lot of work. We've never been able to do it all, you know, with ourselves and kind of financial responsibility, but we've really enjoyed it. As I told someone earlier, a farm is just always work in progress. You never get through with it. There's always something to do. So to see it coming back to where it needs to be has really been a blessing to us.
That's the only way that I would be farming the way I am right now today is because of those programs. But it's not to make money, it's just to better your land for a little less dent in your pocket. But I couldn't ever got to where I'm at today without it.
This particular project is very unique to me. I've been doing this for about 20 years. And typically we'll get 30 or 40 BMPs put in. This one we started out, we didn't have but about $300,000. And to date, we've put in 269 practices. We have about 10 or 12 more to go before we're done with this. But this thing has gone from a $300,000 project to well over $1 million.
Even if they don't have any NRCS.
The open dialogue in this unique watershed process is really what makes it so impactful. It's a chance for the producers to really share what challenges they're having and what solutions they're looking for, so that they're leading the solution to whatever watershed impairment is happening.
What I enjoy most about this 319 project is the relationship with our partners, Mississippi Soil and Water, DEQ, and you guys with Mississippi State. I mean, this allows for everybody to get involved, and it seems like with more people on hands that we can get more done.